Hello. Welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on moving data between scenarios in Oracle Planning and Budgeting Cloud using data management. This demonstration was created using a desktop recording application. In this tutorial, I'll walk through my configuration. Then, create and run a data load rule that copies data from my plan scenario to my draft one scenario. Starting in data management, select the Setup tab. Typically, your planning application is pre-configured as a target application. If not already there, register your application selecting planning as a type. Let's take a look at the application details. Dimension details differ for each application type. Here are the dimension names. The target dimension class is determined by the dimension type. Before data is copied over to the target, it needs to be temporarily stored in data management staging tables. You assign a data management column name to each dimension. Next, import formats. Import formats determine which data columns are extracted from the source system and how they are stored in data management staging tables. The name identifies the import format when you assign it to other configurations such as location. Descriptions are optional. Both source and target are set to EPM and the same application. Drill URLs are not required for this integration. This is where you define the relationship between your source dimensions and target columns. You can choose to load data into a specific member by specifying a default in the expression text box. Next, locations. The location links the import format to the source and target systems. Enter a name. Descriptions are optional. Then, select the import format you defined. The source and target systems are selected for you. Let's talk about period mappings. Period mappings are used to match period formats between the source and target system. Global mappings are shared by applications in your EPM system. The mappings that you create on the Application Mapping tab apply to the target application you select. Source mappings include explicit and adjustment period mappings. Let's move on to data load mappings. Make sure you select the location you defined and the period you'll be importing from. You use data load mappings to derive the target members for each dimension based on source values. You must create a mapping for each dimension you want to export. Options available and the dimension drop-down list depend on the dimensions you configured in your import format. In this example, I've created mappings using the like and explicit mapping types. It's time to create my data load rule. We define and execute data load rules to push data into target applications. Always verify that you have the correct location and POV selected. Enter a data load rule name. Descriptions are optional. Select your category, period mapping type, and source plan type. You can filter the data you want to import in the Source Filters section of the Source Options tab. In this example, I added a source filter for each dimension I'm importing. Remember to save your entries. When you execute the data load rule, make sure import from source and export to target are selected and verify your period selections. The status column displays the current state of the import and export process. Click refresh until you see a checkmark. I'll navigate to the workbench to view the results. The data is staged in data management prior to exporting to the application. I'll open a plan in my planning application to verify that the data was exported. Data was copied from the plan scenario to the draft one scenario. In this tutorial, you saw how to move data between scenarios in Oracle Planning and Budgeting Cloud using data management. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.